Yes, Christmas time, and we thought while the parents are in good mood, it would be nice to ask for the most amazing, you know, something, a favor that we need from them. So we were actually calling our parents during Christmas and asking them if they would want, because both of our parents are actually on already, they're not working. How do you say? They're pensioners?
Yeah.
So they stay at home. They work on their gardens. And we just thought, you know, they're in good mood. They send us some amazing presents. How about we take this opportunity and ask them if they'll be willing to move in with us here and help for a few months with the baby?
Oh, that sounds a little bit opportunistic. Come on.
Or you want to ask your parents a favor when they are pissed about something?
No! It's just like, I don't think that is something that we should have waited, like we have waited for Christmas
to ask. I did wait for a better time to ask. Like, I was not going to ask, like, I'm busy working, I'm pissed about something. Yeah, would you also? I wouldn't ask.
Okay, the point is, in the past weeks, we really had a lot of discussion because, of course, the babies, due date, so to call, is coming soon, and we need to be organized. We are both hardworking person. We have both full jobs that we have
to attend to.
We don't have families here because we are living in a foreign country. So we are thinking, how can we possibly, like, make sure that our child grow in an environment that is family and like
boom. Parents are pensioners. Ask them when they're in good mood.
And good we mood, just said, yes, like, oh, no, not when they are in good mood.
You can you do that. Not ask of somebody when
they're... Oh, come on. There is, out there, there is no... If your mother, if your parents are on pension, there are no parents that would not love to take care of their grandchildren. Really?
Yes, that is true. But to ask them to move in to the country where you're living and move in your apartment and take care, it's a little bit extra. So for me, I thought it made sense that I waited to get a nice opportunity. And around Christmas, people like this, the vibe is good. You can, is that those time, the time of the year where you can almost get away with most of this.
Oh,
it's true though. It's you're young, it's like this is the time you can ask your mother or your father to buy you anything and you have a high chance of getting it.
For me, it was the opposite. It was more like I was threatened. Like if I was not being good, I would say like, okay, Father Christmas is not going to give you any present this year, you know?
No, for me, it was always the time when you can get away with a lot of things. Like I would ask things around Christmas because number one, end of school, you have already your certificate, like your school report, you have good grades. I mean, they're just so excited, and this Christmas, all the families, kids, everybody, cousins are coming together and they're going to party. Why would we not take an opportunity to ask?
Yeah, so if we should pay a third person to live with us, to help us with taking care of the child, or we should instead just ask family. And of course, they said family would be way better. I would love to have like my mother for a few months.
We thought that would be very better. But I have to tell you, when I called my mom, and I'm on the phone saying, before I even finish the sentence of, would you mind moving here to come help us with? You are a grown ass married woman, number one, working. And I have my household to run. So my mother is, I have my own household and my kids to take care of as well at home. So it didn't go as planned. I took a chance, of course, you know, I believe you should ask for some things for you to know if you can get away with it or not. So I did ask, but it didn't go as planned because she was not like, yes, I'm coming. She was more like, you know, I love you and I'm definitely excited that you are expecting
but
child.
Not moving but I thousand of kilometers from my house just to take care of your child grow up.
He said I would be happy to take care of your child, no doubt about it, but you know what, super easy, get on the flight, drop the child here. Yeah, my mother was like that.
No, like more like take the child there
to Namibia.
Yeah, but that for us will not be good because we cannot then have the child with us.
Yeah. But we would never want to leave the farm, move into a small apartment in a country where you've never been. You know, like with your age, I think with age you also become a little bit, I don't know, not so open-minded.
Yeah, you know, you like you don't want to travel anymore and these kind of things.
No, it's not in for you.
When I asked my mother, she was like, yeah, be happy to come, no problem. I just don't know, maybe 3 months is a little bit too much. I will come first for a month at the time and then maybe somebody else can substitute me.
So you're coming for a month?
Yeah.
Your mom?
Yes.
You didn't tell me this. I'm really surprised.
Yes, she's coming for a month.
That's good. Yeah, but okay, I can understand. For your mother, it's also, if you're living in Germany, you're living in Italy, maybe the environment is a little bit similar.
Mm-hmm.
For my, yes, in terms of life, standard of living.
Okay. My parents, they have a lot of open space. Yes. It's more like being in the village.
No, I get that. But in terms of the whole neighborhood, going to the supermarket and all this, it's a little bit of a familiar environment.
Okay.
In my parents. Okay. In the absence of the animals.
Yeah, in the absence of the good food.
We cook good food here.
We?
Yes, so it's going to live with us. I'll be cooking. I don't know.
Whatever you will be cooking.
But I'll be, we cook
maybe
good
some prawns.
For my mother, I think is obviously is used to a different tradition.
Mm-hmm.
If you want me to take care of your child, which she'll be very happy to do, but only under one condition. The child has to go to Namibia.
So your mother is excluded, she's not coming?
My mother is not moving to the city.
Oh, not at all.
You know that I lived in the city before, in Windhoek?
Yeah.
So that was like 800 kilometers by car. Would come maximum 2 days.
Maximum 2 days, and then I'm busy. Oh, well, all that road, I mean, there is like, you say, 8 hours road from your village.
The longest that she has stayed at our, in my apartment in Windhoek was a week.
Oh, wow.
It's not about I don't want to be with you, but it's really about
I can't live in this box.
Yes, like I cannot breathe, there's no air in there, you know, like you feel you're in a box because you're used to really open space and then there are not enough activities to do. Have you seen how
busy
a village person is from morning to evening?
You grow mahangu pounding, then
you wake up at 6 feeding the chicken. After that you go to the pork, you go to the kettle place. There is always work. It's not like you wake up here at 9, you're having a cup of coffee.
Watch TV.
Never watch TV. Would never watch it. So 2 days is complaining like crazy because it make her feel like, oh, my life, what kind of life am I living where I only eat? My mother would say, eat, go poo and sleep. What kind of life is that?
Yeah, but that is our life, I'm sorry to say.
If we had, which we can also maybe get, like a chicken on the balcony.
Oof, maybe only one.
No, two!
No, one is enough, come on.
Two, can make eggs. Then she can collect eggs.
Every day she goes.
Is the chicken
amazing? But it's so sad, the chicken in the cage. Where are you going?
We give it to a little bit. The whole balcony is just...
Okay, who is going to be cleaning the poo?
Exactly, that's not the job of the village movement. Yeah, if we had a little something more, would have been heavy. But I think now...
It's not coming. I'm really curious, what would you prefer, like, to have an help from an external person that you are paying, or would you rather call your mom, see if she's available, and just ask her if she can move for a period to your house and help you to take care of the child?
I would say, I think everybody would, I would first prefer a family member.
I'm not asking you, I'm asking our audience.
You don't know my opinion?
Oh yeah, I know your opinion already.
So I would say, let me tell you, obviously with a family member, I think you feel so safer, It's just now my thought. But in case you can't get a family member, then you have to rely on a nanny. Although, if it was not for me, if it was not during the COVID era, I would also not mind having just a nanny. The issue here is that nannies, they come in the morning and they go in the evening.
Yeah.
And with this COVID thing, I don't think I want to have somebody taking a Uber every day going to middle of Berlin or wherever and coming back. That was pretty much it. Or do you have anything extra to add?
No, I would say that is it. Mama Flummy, we are waiting for you.
Are you happy?
Yeah.
You say thank you?
Of course, in advance.
And do you send a thank you gift already?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we have a thank you video.
You have a thank you video, yeah. I still don't feel your energy. I saw a lint
package. Just I didn't take my coffee in the evening, so I'm a little bit more like, it's a drop, thank you. It's
yeah, fine. This is quite strong, really.
No, I don't believe that.
Triple espresso.
No, that is triple water.
Triple. Thank you so much for watching. And see you in our next video.
Yeah,
how many more days in the new year? How many more days?
4 days.
Oh, today is the 27th. Wait a second. I'm confused. I mean, from home office to Christmas holiday, which 27.
Can we close this video?
Yes. So New Year is going to be on Friday. Haha, so our next video is going to be released on the new year. That's guys, that was it.
Ciao, ciao, ciao.